The whole world is facing a pandemic, and the whole world is in a worry, and all are trying to tackle this problem of coronavirus and COVID-19, that is COVID-19, and it is a novel virus, and no medicine for that, no vaccination, and that worried the whole world that how to tackle this problem, how to contain this virus. The virus occurred in Wuhan first, but at that time itself, our state, Kerala, started the preparation to resist that virus. We anticipated that people from Wuhan will return to Kerala because so many Keralites are there in Wuhan, China. And when we happen to hear the novel virus, that is a virus in a corona family and the SARS family, we thought that the virus will come to Kerala. And January, second week itself, we started our preparation here. We had a previous experience on Nipah virus outbreak. At that time, it is a newly emerging zoonosis, and we didn't know what is behavior and how to contain this high mortality rate of virus. And but at that time, we prepared a protocol, a standard operating practice, and we started contact tracing, quarantine, etc., to contain Nipah virus. And our system, we put our system in alert, and good training and everything done at that time. And with that experience, we thought that this virus also is like that. If the spreading, it is a spreading type virus, even though the mortality rate is low, but the infectivity rate is high. And in a state like Kerala, where is a thickly populated state, it will become very dangerous if the virus came to Kerala. That is why we started earlier, the preparation started earlier. January second week, we have had our RRT meeting, rapid response team meeting, and also we constituted our control room here, state level control room, and we formed 18 expert team, as in the case of Nipah virus. At that time, we also constituted an expert team to act. And this time also, we constituted team and we gave charge to the additional director and officers, and they should get ready to tackle the thing if it came to Kerala. And we started training and other thing. Every team should have to do their own work before the virus entering to Kerala. And as we expected, January 27th, flight from Wuhan reached here, and there are 72 passengers from Wuhan in that flight, and we traced them in the airport itself. Our help desk was there in the airport, and we traced and examined the passengers thoroughly, and the symptomatic cases we shifted to hospital. Asymptomatic cases, we send them to to their home for a strict home quarantine. We prepared the guidelines for home quarantine earlier, and we gave it to the passengers when they went back to their home, and insisted strict home quarantine to obey our strict principles. And that work yielded a very good result. Only three positive cases we got from the Wuhan issue, and all the others were kept away from these positive cases. Very good quarantine system and good isolation. And we treated the positive cases properly, and all the three recovered and went back to their home. And people thought that it is the end, and the virus will never came back, or no other incident will occur. But our health department and our government our chief minister asked us to take every precaution, because we cannot predict whether the virus will come again or not. And we continued our vigilance in Kerala. And we didn't withdraw the screening team from the airport. Instead of that, we gave training to more volunteers or more officers, a screening team. And we we have 4 international airport in this small state. And one part it is positive, but the virus contamination or virus transfer, it is not positive, because all the 4 airport, through the airport, people will came back. We have to listen carefully. And we have our contact tracing team in the tracing team in all the 4 airport, and we give them proper training, and we put them there. And after 2 weeks, when the first Wuhan case discharged from the hospital, after 2 weeks, we found that the virus is spreading in Italy and all over the world, to UK, USA, etc. And we eagerly waited to find out whether they are coming from other countries or not. And as we expected, the people from other countries also reached here. Out of that, we got several positive cases. We traced them properly. Our strategy is tracing, quarantining, testing, isolating, and treating. We followed that method as early as possible. And we have very good protocol, and we made very good standard operating practices, and also advisories to all the departments. The health department prepared advisories for all the other departments. We continued our vigilance and work here. And up to May 1st week, we got 499 cases, out of which 3 of them died. We cannot prevent death, because all the 3 people were, they have comorbidities and they were in a sick condition. And we tried our best, but they died. But we saved a 93-year-old man and 88-year-old woman who got the virus from Italy returned relatives. And we have a very good treatment in our hospital, and we saved their lives also. That was a great victory. But 3 died out of this virus. And it is under our control at that time. March 24 onwards, the lockdown also declared. And it is easy to contain this thing, because at that time, due to the lockdown, no others are coming back again from other states or other countries. These cases are under our control, and we traced the contact and isolated them properly. But after April, when May started, month of May, the situations changed again. And when the lifting of the stringent actions happened, when the lockdown lifted, again the flight service reinstated, and also the road and surface travel also reinstated. By water also, ships are coming. And that time again, we are getting positive cases here. Once we flattened the curve more than anything, and everyone asked us how is it possible to flatten the curve, and the mortality rate is too low in Kerala. How are you doing this? What is your principle? Everyone inquired us. We said that it is nothing but the early preparedness and continuous working, continuous vigilance. Each day we are conducting meeting. Our chief minister is conducting meeting of all the department and discussing the matter. How is the situation in the the 14 districts? And we are evaluating that thing. And we are taking final decisions after that. And we are meeting the press each and every day, briefing everything to the society through medias. We want to kept everything in a transparent method. Every death we are reporting, every positive case we are reporting, and if anyone is serious or ventilated in the ICUs, that also we are reporting. how many patients are stable in hospital and how many are in a severe condition. Everything we are reporting to the society. And also we are reporting how many people are under our vigilance, how many people are under home quarantine, and how many are in the institutional quarantine, and how many are admitted in the hospital, and hospital vigilance, etc. Everything we are reporting to the society, and we are giving the method of breaking the chain also, how to break the chain. The most important part to contain the severe virus is to break the chain of the transmission. And we introduced some campaigns of our own to break the chain. SMS campaign, means S means soap or sanitizer, M means mask, and also the last S means the social distance. We are insisting people to keep physical distance with each other, and also wearing mask when they are coming out, washing their hands with soap occasionally, and how to break the chain. And we introduced the reverse quarantine also. As we all know, the vulnerable group is the old aged people and persons who are more than 70 years, 65 or 70 years old, they are more vulnerable to these diseases. If they caught the virus, most of them are succumbed to death. We found it in other countries. That is the news coming from USA, UK, Italy, etc. In some countries, they denied treatment to the old age people above 70. They are not attending that people because their hospitals are flooded with the patients and they cannot give attention to the poor old age people. But in Kerala, we started the reverse quarantine earlier. Means the above 60 or 65, they should remain in their home properly. They should not come to contact with the returnees, the other countries, people are who are coming came from abroad. We are not allowing to have a contact to this vulnerable group. Not only old age, but also pregnant women are differently abled people and people, the persons who have other comorbidities, severe other diseases, we are keeping them away from the returnees from other states or other epic center or the hotspots. And that is not an easy process, but we are using all our machineries for that. All departments are working together. I have with me the Women and Children and the Social Justice Department also. And we trained the Anganwadi workers and helpers to how they can move to the houses of the old age people and to train them to stand inside, to stay inside the home. And what should they have to listen? And their behavioral change also we need, because it is not easy to put them in house, inside the house throughout a long period. But we are soothing them by giving counselings and some activities inside the home. And they are calling, Anganwadi workers and helpers are calling. They called more than 42 lakhs of peoples throughout Kerala. And a very good result out of that. And also our ASHA workers are going to the home by field work. And they are listening whether they have medicine for non-communicable diseases, for diabetes, and also for the hypertension and some cancer, etc. They want medicines. They cannot move outside because we should ensure that they are getting their medicines. And we are supplying medicines to their doorsteps through Kerala Medical Service Corporation. We are collecting medicines and supplying to their doorsteps. I am KK Shailaja teacher, Kerala Health Minister. And I think eminent personalities are participating in this discussion or this meeting, and I want to convey my best wishes to all. All of us are working hard. No one is standing still. But the virus is like that. It is a spreading type, and it is not easy to flatten the curve of the virus or easy to tackle the problem. We are watching the conditions of the world itself, and it is a dangerous situation. But we should believe in science. Only science can save us, nothing else. And the scientific world will find out a vaccine. This is not the first time that the virus is coming to the world. So many viruses are there, H1N1, H5N1, and that kind of so many viruses are here. And we addressed all that virus previously. And for some virus, we find out a vaccine also, and also medicine also. And our scientists are working throughout the world to find out a vaccine against this virus, corona or COVID-19. And also some medicine for this virus. I have hope that the science world will find out a vaccine or a medicine. But it will take time. The experiments are going on. It will take time. But we should do some preventive measures now as much as we can. And that is what we are doing here. Breaking the chain, that is the most important thing. Please try to break the chain. Don't allow the transmission from one human being to other. We should work on that. Only that way we can save the most lives, more lives from this virus. And I want to convey my best wishes to all people around the world and in our country who are working day and night to tackle this virus, this dangerous thing. And we will succeed. Definitely, we will succeed. And my best wishes to all of you.